Hello everybody, welcome back to the Hull City Career Mode Episode 2. Today, we'll start off getting straight into it, the final group game of the friendlies against Montpellier. Couple of changes for today, Diamandi up top, Al Mohammadi on the right side of the midfield, Davies in at centre back. Welcome to match day 3 of the European Shield, Hull City versus Montpellier of France. And we're underway here with Hull. Sessegnon pushing. Sessegnon found some space down the right. Placed out wide for Ninga. Here's Ninga now. Squares himself up against Curtis Davies. Davies loses his man and Marshall collects. Larsen's throw. Mason intercepts Diamandi to Evandro. Evandro hits it and Bertaud saves it for the first save of the game. So here we see Diamandi is having to go off due to injury. Abel Hernandez is the man to replace him. The man has not been in form, so he needs to improve today. Now Mohammadi plays it forward to him again. Dolly, Sessegnon, Lasner. Lasner on the edge, plays it wide to McKaylee. Here's McKaylee, shoots, and it's over the bar. Mohammadi has found Evandro now. Plays it out wide, he's picked out Robertson. Robertson. Blocked again by McKaylee. Evandro plays it through. He's picked out Al-Mohammadi, who hits it from range. And what a save by Bertaud. And McKaylee's there again, clearing it. As we're going at half time, Hull City nil, Montpellier nil. Ninga. He's played it out wide to Sessegnon. Back to Ninga. He's Ninga now with space. He's played it through to Sanson. Sanson found a bit of space. He's giving Dolly, who shoots. Good effort there by Marshall. Saves it and Mason clears it out to touch. And there's the challenge that broke down Davies. Davies will have to go off injured. So Henriksen and Harry Maguire coming on. Curtis Davies and Evandro going off. Henriksen again. He's found Abel Hernandez. Henriksen shoots. Good effort there from Henriksen. As we look again here at Henriksen's effort. Hull getting closer, but also Montpellier getting closer. Remains 0-0. Alria Budabuz. Budabuz finding space, running at the back four. Oh, he's played it wide now to Roussillon. Here's Roussillon. Puts it in. Oh, what a save from Marshall from range. Al Mohammadi clears it. Mason stopped by Lassner there. Lassner's pushing forward. Harry Maguire is his man in front of him. Oh, it's late, but nothing. Lassner stays on his feet. Back to Ninga. Ninga now. He's surrounded by Hull players. He's found half a yard. Can he play it across? And he shoots. And what a save again by Marshall. Shkivi there, coming close. Al Mohammadi was just muscled off the ball. Pits out Ryan Mason. Ryan Mason plays it forward. Abel Hernandez holds the ball. He's got nobody with him. Robertson. Al Mohammadi on the edge. He shoots. Good save by Murtaud. Al Mohammadi there turning his man from the edge and putting an effort in. Great save. And it's full time here. Hull City nil, Montpellier nil. Hull City will progress to the knockout stages. So as we look at the injuries from the Montpellier match, we've got Adama Diamande out with a sprained ankle for 4 weeks. Also, we've got Curtis Davies out with a sprained ankle for 4 weeks. As we can see here now, Sunderland have matched the £2 million counteroffer for Sean Maloney, and he will be on his way. Red Bull Leipzig have come back in, saying they'll only pay $5.5 million for Abel Hernandez. It's not going to cut it. We'll go for 6.7, see what they say. So with the injury now of Davies, we're looking short at the back, so we're going to make an offer right now for Lamine Okone. Going to go in with a £4.5 million bid and see what Sunderland say. Semi-final match coming up against AZ Alkmaar. Few changes again for Hull today, continuing the rotation. We've got Wilkeen coming in up top, Marcus Emerson at cam, Tom Huddlestone in the middle for Alfred, and Michael Dawson at centre back for Ranocchia. It's semi-final day here in Portugal for the European Shield, Hull City versus AZ Alkmaar of Holland. And we're underway in the semi-final of the European Shield. Lucas summons it to Van Overeem. He is Rienstra. Rienstra with a ball through, looking for Ali Reza. Ali Reza trying to find half a yard. Puts it tight, he puts it across towards Dawson, and Weghorst does put it in. 1-0 Azad. So as we look here, ball played in, got the wrong side of his man. Weghorst scores. 1-0 Azad. Markovic to Huddleston. He's played it out wide to Omar. Goes inside now looking for Niace. He's picked out Huddleston. Huddleston plays it across the box looking for Will Keane at the back post, who's made it 1-1. Brilliant bit of movement there from Hull. Huddleston found a bit of space. Sees Will Keane at the back post. What a header. Keeper had no chance. Van Overeem wins it off Huddleston. He's got space on the edge. He plays it through to Weghorst and it's almost in. Beat the keeper, beat the post. Found half a yard on the edge. First time shot. Good effort. At the end of an eventful first half, it's Hull City 1, AZ Alkmaar 1. Huddleston plays it out wide looking for Will Keane. Will Keane's brought down hard by Voitens. It's going to be a yellow card. Stijn Vroetens going to be on eggshells now. Will Keane was finding space. Goes down like a sack of spuds. So Ryan Mason went down under a challenge. He's going to have to be subbed off the pitch here. And it's Evandro coming on. Ryan Mason going off. Van Overeem out to Haps. Inside to Van Overeem. He's picked out David Dos Santos. David Dos Santos stopped by Dawson, but only for Balassani. Balassani, will he hit it from range? He has, and what a save. One-handed there. Henriksen to Niace. To Henriksen. Plays it through to Keane, and Keane, it's 2-0. 2-1 rather. Hull City take the lead for the first time. Will Keane. As we look here, Umar Niace played it to Henriksen. Henriksen's weighted pass through to Keane and he slots it in the back of the net. Hull City 2, AZ Alkmaar 1. Haps has found a lot of space down the left wing again. He's put across the box and Fred, oh what a header. As you can see here, Hapsi's ball played across and Fred Friday, what a header and what a save from Marshall. Markovic. Van Eyden plays it through to David Dos Santos. Dawson's caught out position and Marshall collects. Well, Keane plays it forward. He's found Robertson in space. Robertson is still going. Balassani's chasing him and he's brought down in the penalty area. It is a penalty. Hull City could snatch it here and confirm the 3 points and their place in the final. Robertson looked like he was just about to release the cross and Balassani brings him down. There's only one man that can take this and it's going to be Will Keane on his hat-trick. Runs up, slots it in, Coutinho didn't even try. Will Keane, shock starter, has scored an hat-trick. Calm as you like from the Englishman, he runs up and slots it just to the keeper's left. Will Keane makes it 3-1 to Hull City, 3 goals to him. And there you have it, your man of the match with his hat-trick, receiving the ball. Will Keane of Hull City, fantastic performance. Full-time score, Hull City 3, AZ Alkmaar 1. So as we look at the full-time scores on the other side of the match, it is Montpellier that progressed to the final to face Hull City, a replay of the group match. And as we take a look at Ryan Mason's injury, he is out for 8 days with a bruised elbow. And as we take a look here, Sunderland are demanding $8 million for Lamine Kone. Now, I will go back in for him, but I won't be paying that much. I'll pay 5.5 and see what they come back and say. After Wilkins' heroics from the last game scoring that hat trick, he will be removed from the loan list and he will be given an opportunity at the club. He was absolutely fantastic in that game. And there you can see confirmation, Sean Maloney has gone to Sunderland for £2 million. We get £1.4 million. Red Bull Leipzig have also matched the £6.7 million counter offer for Abel Hernandez, so he will be moving out of the club. So as we head into the cup final of the friendly tournament, both teams are going to wear their away kits. Kamal Grzycki is coming on the right side of the midfield. Henriksen's coming for the injured Ryan Mason. And Will Keane maintains his position up top. It's cup final day here in Portugal. We've got Montpellier of France versus Hull City. So as the players head onto the pitch, they get to look at that trophy. And as you can see, no Portuguese teams made it. Disappointing for the home supporters, but at least they get to see a spectacle between Hull and Montpellier. Will Keane there, being targeted by the cameraman, scored a hat-trick in his last match. Let's see if he can push it forward. And as we look at the Montpellier team, it's pretty much the same as the team that played him in the league. De Plonge comes in at right back though. And I think pretty much everyone else, that's it, as is. And that's what the teams are playing for today, the European trophy. DiddyRadar sends Hull out basically the same as what he has done all through, rotating his squad. Will Keane keeps his position. Henriksen's coming for the injured Ryan Mason. Grzycki's on the right of midfield for Markovic. And Hull kickers off, and we're underway in this cup final. Sessegnon from range, poor. Disappointing there from the experienced midfielder. Came from nothing though, but should have done better. So we've got yet another injury to a whole play. This time Omar Alabdallawi. And here comes his replacement, Moses Adeboji. Will Keane found Robertson in space. Robertson looking for Omar Nies. Nies pulls it back, looking for his man, and it's missed by Evandro. Robertson onto Henriksen at the edge of the area. Henriksen can't find no space, gives it to Grzycki, who shoots from range. Jodran, did he get a touch on that? It seems he did. Grzycki there, gains some space, plays it across. And Jodran, fingertip save around the post. Good save. Congre. Robertson gets it. He's found Henriksen on the edge. Stopped, but Alfred and Dye now. Evandro. And Dye shoots. Comfortable for Jodran. Henriksen now. Walks over the halfway line. Plays it up wide to Grzycki. Grzycki cuts inside. Block, but Evandro's found space. He's Henriksen now. Henriksen shoots. He's found the back of the net. It's in off the post. Marcus Henriksen makes it 1-0 Hull. As you can see here, just dawdling on the edge, found off a yard, turned his man and hit in off the post. Quality finish. Keeper absolutely had no chance there. So as we go in at half time, it's Montpellier 0, Hull City 1. Montpellier's through at Rousselon, into Dolly. Rousselon. He's got space here now. If he's dawdled on the ball and Alfred stops him again. And he's injured. Ninga puts it across the box. And Paul Lasny's put it in. 1-1. Montpellier equalise, but they have got a man down should the play have stopped. Ninga found space, puts his cross, Lasna beats his man in the air. Robertson caught off guard today, not been great. Yes, on the edge to Grisicki's Henriksen now. He shoots, oh, it's deflected wide. So close again from Henriksen. As you can see here, he got his all caught up and it was just deflected in the opposite direction. Normally he's got turned in. Silla. Ninga. It's Ninga trying to break. He's played through Riyad Budabuz. Budabuz makes an effort and it's wide. Dolly pushing left flank. Long ball forward. Ruzalon has got space here. Moses goes in and what a challenge. Corner ball. Budabuz, front post, he's found Meunier. Meunier's brought down by Moses. It's a penalty, Montpellier. Moses Odebarjo concedes the penalty. Did a bit of brilliance and then that was just clumsy from the youngster. Budabuz lines up, Marshall goes down right. Oh, the keeper went the right way, but Budabuz has found the back of the net. Budabuz confidently puts it in. Marshall was just beaten. Henriksen ball through to Embakani. He's Embakani now. Holds up play, plays it back to Henriksen. He's gone to Endai. Endai plays it across towards Grzycki, who shoots from range and Jodran saves it again. Henriksen to Embakani. Embakani's brought down hard. And Embakani will face a yellow card here in the cup final. We're into injury time. Can Hull snatch an equaliser? It was reckless by Embakani as he went in at the same time as Ruzalon. Hull's got a chance. Referee making sure all the players are back. Seems to be a lot of build up. It's taking his time. Grzycki, red faced, standing over the ball as it stands. It is Grzycki. Grzycki lines it up. He's going to shoot from here. Oh, and he's put it over. Kamil Grzycki has just blown the opportunity to get an equaliser. Poor free kick. Henriksen wins it back again. He's played in Wilkeen. Wilkeen now. Oh, he's brought down in the box by Bob Mongkongu. What the hell has gone on with Montpellier? They are panicking at the back. And Mongkongu's being called over by the ref. What's his decision going to be? It's a yellow card. Wilkeen scored a penalty in the last match, steps up with a chance to equalise. He runs up, he shoots, he's put it past Jodran. Wilkeen has equalised. The young Englishman has come from nowhere in this tournament and scored 4-3 in 2 games. He seems to have pushed his way into the first team picture. 2-2 Hull. And that's the full-time whistle. It's Montpellier 2, Hull City 2. This will be settled at a penalty shootout. Montpellier get first penalty. Riyad Budabuz scored one. Marshall sends him the wrong way. Wilkeen now steps up. Oh, and he's fluffed it. Mongkongu, should he still be on the pitch, be taking one? Puts it, shoots, and he's put it wide. Marshall went the wrong way. Embakani now, chance to equalise. Runs up. And he's put it in. Meunier taking a long run up here. David Marshall in goal. Whoa, the ball seemed to stick in the air and it's 2-1. Komal Grosicki running. And he rolls it in. Hilton now. Again, another long run up. Marshall staying calm. And Hilton's put it over. He hit the ball. Klukas. Chance to give Hull the lead now for the first time in the shootout. And Jordan has saved it. Lasney came on and changed the game for Montpellier. And it's saved by Marshall. Oh, Hull could win it here now. Marcus Henriksen, been the best player on the pitch today. He runs up. And he's put it in. Marcus Henriksen has got the winner in the penalty shootout. Hull City win on penalties. They are the European champions. Marcus Henriksen, man of the match. And here it is, the match winning penalty. Marcus Henriksen, calm as you like. So full time it was 2-2. 3-2 to Hull City on penalties. Hull City win. So as we get ready now, the players are about to lift the trophy. There's Henriksen, followed by Captain Robertson. You can see the joy in the players' faces, and there it is. Andrew Robertson lifting the trophy. The European Continental Shield, even though it's a trophy, Hull City are the winners. First order of business, goalkeeper offers. Gonna Jordan Pickford, straight in, 7 million. Alternative goalkeeper offer, Thomas Vaklic, 77 overall, going for 6 million bid from Basel. Another centre back option we're going in for, Ben Gibson, going in at value from Middlesbrough. Young English. Left back options, Papa Suave of Crystal Palace, going in for a cheeky low ball offer, 3 million. Charlie Taylor is also an option and going for 2 million. He has only got a last year of his contract. And then finally, Ridziano Haps, great player to use, go in, valuation offer for my AZ Alkmaar. So now we move on to midfield signings. We've got Marvellous Nakamba of Vitesse, £2.1 million valuation offer. I wonder if he could be a Marvellous player. Next up, Kamohelo Makoto from FC Twent. Been there a number of years now. South African international. So, we'll go in again, valuation offer. In attack, we'll make a bid, £2 million. Vaclav Kadlec, also from Basel. We have Moses Simon from Ghent, really pacey player, going in at 4.5 for him. We have Jonathan Caleri of West Ham, never worked out for him at the Hammers, ended up staying I think, I'm not sure if he went or not, I'm assuming he stayed but he's still there, but I rated him a couple of FIFAs ago, so I'm going to give him a go again. And then finally for now, on these current offers, Danny Ings of Liverpool, Englishman, 23 years old, everyone knows him, £9 million. Once again, Sunderland have rejected the offer for Lamine Kone, will go back in, £6.5 million. Northampton Town have come in for a loan for Ben Enchcliffe. Transfer for Kamal Grzycki, he's only just come in, I'm going to reject all offers, disallow future offers, at least until January. Jordan Pickford's also rejected, said they want 12, he is my main target, going for 9. And as you can see there, Abel Hernandez has gone to Red Bull Leipzig, 6.7 million. Makoto, they have accepted a valuation offer of 3 million, So we'll give him the contract he's requesting of 10 grand a week, 3 years. Sunderland have accepted the £6.5 million bid for Kone. So we'll give him the 40 grand a week, 3 year contract. So 18-year-old Nordi Mukiele played really well against Montpellier in the group. So I'm going to go in and make an offer. He's more of a future player. £6 million for Moses Simon has been accepted. We'll go in, 15.5 grand, 4 year contract. 2.8 million offer has been accepted for Marvelous. So we will go in, give him his contract offer, go from there. Another striker we're going to look at, Kasper Dahlberg. I'm going to go straight in, 6 million valuation offer. I'm going to look at Andre Onana, young Ajax goalkeeper. I'm going to go in for 3 million as a backup because I think the Basel keeper is going to cost way too much. Danny Ings has declined his contract offer. At 80 grand a week, I'm unsure whether to even pursue this deal. We'll keep the... remove the squad role completely. He says he wants a greater squad role. We'll continue negotiations though. 9 million is accepted for Caleri. We'll go in 80 grand, 4 years. And the first player to accept his contract is Carmelo Makotio, CDM, South African. He's going to come into midfield for £3 million, 10 grand a week. So the £6.5 million offer was accepted for Haps. Give him his contract offer, what he's asking for, and see what he says. £7.5 million for Vaklic has been accepted. We'll give him 25 grand a week, see how it goes. £9 million Jordan Pickford accepted, so we'll go in 4 years, 25 grand a week. £2.7 million offer was rejected. A £2.8 million one's been accepted. So we'll send pretty much the same offer, but an extra £10. 3 million, Vaclav Kadlec has been accepted. So 30 grand a week, 3 year contract. Second signing coming in through the door, we've got Lamine Kone, centre back, £6.5 million, 40 grand a week. Offer for Nordi Mukiele has come through. We'll give him the contract, see where we go. Marvelous Nakamba's accepted his 9 grand a week contract, £2.8 million. Welcome to the club. Ben Gibson deal's been accepted at £2.8 million. So we're going to offer him a contract slightly higher because another club is in for him. Next player through the doors of another Sunderland player, Jordan Pickford, £9 million, 25 grand a week. Now I do have Caleri, Ings, Vaklic and Haps also agreed. Vaklic is no longer needed, so he will leave and be rejected. Haps, Ings and Caleri are all going to be on stall for now. So Ajax have accepted the offer that we put in for him, Kasper Dahlberg. So we'll give him a contract offer and see where we go. Nordi Mukiele, the youngster from Montpellier, is going to join, 800 grand a week. £4,000 a week wages. Ben Gibson has also accepted £2.8 million, 22 grand a week. Alice Blackworth, young centre back, going on loan to Bristol Rovers. As it stands, the budget is massively cut. I'm gonna have to wait to try and sell players before we can bring anybody else in. But I think we've done some good business up to now. And that's gonna wrap up episode 3. Thank you all for watching. Next time when we come back, it'll be opening day fixture against Premier League holders, Leicester City. So for me, DiddyRadar, I will catch you all next time.